Hi guys, it's Hassan from Hike, and as you can see, I've progressed even further now with since I've got Nakai San's Porsche 911 Carrera. And this car, it's not my style, to be honest. It looks next level, don't get me wrong, but it's not my style. This car, what, it's more about its grip, but when it exits corners, it's really fast. It knows how to exit corners, but other than that, it's not my style. I like, you know, drifting and everything. This hardly ever drifts. You have to put a lot of braking and like trying to handbrake to try and make it drift. But however, I've done a few events, so I'm slowly building everyone up to more than 50%. If I can show you here, I'm looking at my NFS, and as you can see, I've got style a lot. I've got speed more than halfway. How long I'm going to leave to last, because it's all about the police and everything, and I'm going to do edit challenge try at the end as well. Look, I've build's got to 61%. I'm going to do crew as well. I'm going to try getting them all to about 80-90%, and then record all the last final details. But since I'm going away on holiday in about 2 days from now, I'll try getting as much videos as I can on this game. And yeah, so let's get into it. The stats of this car, as you can see on mine, I've keyed it up a little bit more. I'll show you that in a second. But you know, with it, it's I think 344 horsepower Porsche, but it's got around, oh, you can go a top speed of, I think, about 200 miles per hour, 190-200 miles per hour, and a quarter mile at about 11.4 seconds. However, minus on GTR, I was gonna sell this. I had a point where I was gonna sell this and make it have get the GTR, the older version, from it. As you can see here now, it's at 2.33 seconds at 9.93 seconds at a quarter mile. Top speed of 231 and a horsepower 886. But I've noticed this car doesn't hit that top speed. It don't hit 231 miles per hour. I'm not sure why. I think it's probably been restricted or something. It only gets to like 170 and that's it. Just not slow. Like, it just stays at 170. So, and once I fully customized everything up, I'll see how it goes. But as you can see at the moment, I haven't changed much on it. I've just added Hike stickers to the side and that's it, and a black roof. That's what I added on. But however let's get into a thingy, a race. And this is one thing I'm not liking about this game. It's like, do you know how you drive, how the game feels? The game don't feel perfect. It feels a bit stiff, you know, in the cars, like when you've come out of a drift and you've done the drift wrong. It's like the car, when you try to straighten yourself, it won't straighten, just hit straight into a wall, or it's hard to straighten the car out. That's the only thing I don't like about it. And the worst thing when you spawn out there is that if a car's there, you just hit straight into it. Let's just try to show you what I mean. Let me try to find a good corner. Let's see. Follow this corner around, but for example, once you get the drift right, it's alright, but then if you don't get the drift right, it's like the car will start like going this way, and you have to keep tapping it this way. It'll go towards the right side. I mean, if you come out a drift from the right side and you get the drift wrong, it'll come out towards the right side and you have to keep tapping left to get the car back straight again. And that's one thing I don't like. But anyway, let's get into someone's mission. Let's see, who should we go? Yeah, and I've got, as you can see, Manu's events. I've finally got Ken and Manu. That means I'm gonna probably have Ken Block's Mustang soon anyway. But more than the Mustang, do you know what one, which one I like? I love the Ford Focus RS he had. I think that was next level. This one's what I think is about 860 horsepower Mustang. But the old one of our Ford Focus RS, I think it's 1.9 seconds 0-60. And no car can do that. That is ultimate. But anyway, let's try this, because I've had this there for a long time and let's finally get it beaten. What I noticed about this game, it needs to get into a better level. You know, like that Opus game, like Forza Horizon 3, like that. Stop crashing me, pricks. Forza Horizon 3, that's what you need, a game like Forza Horizon 3. It's a time trial shit. I thought you'd think it drifted then. But you need a game like Forza Horizon 3. That game has got what? It's got probably the gameplay mechanics of like how Drive Club is. Like Drive Club mixed in with the drifting from Need for Speed. But you fucking not. But it's got game like, you know, the scenery and everything. It's like proper. Like, did you see that? Look, my car did that jump. It landed and it just dropped speed, so much speed. Get the wheel of this car back. I think because it's my first match since I've woken up, it's about 2 o'clock out here, but the thing is that I just need to start playing a little bit more, maybe a little bit better. However, yeah, what I was saying now, Forza Horizon 3, it's got, you know, it's gonna be a game that's gonna be on a totally different level. It's gonna be, I think, if PlayStation ever made a game like that, I think that would be an extra successor. We need a game like that. Drive Club was alright. It's more track based, you know, like it wasn't open world like this was, like how Need for Speed is. And also Project Cars, that's more track based as well. That's rivaling Drive Club. You got that Assetto Corsa, I think that's coming out. That's gonna be another track based game. I'm not sure if it's open world. I haven't like really checked it. I've just seen the picture of it. But we need someone out there, there's someone that's gonna put PlayStation back onto this game, because right now I think Xbox leading in the game driving games. Same with, you know, because I've stopped playing Black Ops now, Black Ops 3. The new, what was it now, Infinity Warfare, is coming out. And Infinity Warfare, that's not a game I'm gonna buy. It's just, if you see how the timeline's been going up, it's been going up and up. That's bye bye. And it's been going up and up, and it's like going more in the future, 2025, 2035, 50 and all this, 65. And now it's just getting to a point where we don't know how the future is going to be. As you know, Britain's left the EU and I'm from Great Britain, so you don't know how the future is going to be. I think that was a fucking stupid move as well. But how Infinity Warfare is continuing into the future, Battlefield's going back in time, and that's what people want. People, they thought, yeah, Advanced Warfare was good. Don't get me wrong, Advanced Warfare, I love that game. That game was somewhat different. Because from jumping at, like, running on the ground to flying about, I think that's what changed everything. But, because you could do, like, with Advanced Warfare, you could, what the heck is this? There's a thingy on the map. It's like an electricity ball. What's this? But it's like, for example, Advanced Warfare is like when you used to jump, if you jump too far forward, you can jump back, or you can hold circle and jump yourself all the way down. Then Black Ops 3 came, it had the mechanics were alright, but you know, when you like jumped, you couldn't jump back down, you had to like float back down. Like, if you hold it X for too long, and watch your guy was flying up to the max, he floats back down, and it's in that time someone can kill you, and that's the worst thing. Advanced Warfare, you could have pulled circle and your guy would have slammed straight back to the ground. And that's what I liked about that. It's Infinity Warfare, that's not going to do well. Because Battlefield's overtaken it. And I'll tell you one thing. Since everyone's wanted to go back into the time, like from World at War. Like World at War, when it came, was a good game. I thought it was a good game anyway. You had, because you had tanks and stuff in that. You could drive tanks and stuff. But then you got Modern Warfare. You got Modern Warfare first, then World of War, then you got Modern Warfare 2, and that, I'm not gonna lie, that was the greatest game of all time, because that was one of the first games, Call of Duty, that I played, that I started going good at, and Battlefield has gone back to that era where it's got the Zeppelins, it's got the fighter planes, it's got, you know, tanks, everything, and that's what you need. You got the old school guns, you think you got the PPSH, you got the Type 41, the one with the big ass magazine on top of the gun. That's what you need. Anyway, that's all my thoughts. That's my thoughts for the future of Call of Duty. I'll probably buy Battlefield, not so much Call of Duty, Infinity Warfare. However, let's get in one more race and we leave it at that. I need to beat Magnus to count to 250 horsepower. I don't know what to get for that. Forgot what I got last time, so let me just do a sprint race or Robin. Where's Robin? It's there, Crescent Mines. Let's jump straight there. Let's see. We'll do one more race after this. This is the last race, I mean. Let's see how this race goes. This game, you know what I like? The best Need for Speed that I think was most wanted is obviously an Underground. But that was one, for the last, for the PS3, I think the best one probably was most likely. You had Most Wanted again, the second version. And then you also had Hot Pursuit. I think Hot Pursuit was sick. Hot Pursuit was a sick game. Need for Speed Run was shit. That's probably the worst Need for Speed you can get. But the rest, oh shit, you have to drift, alright. Oh my gosh, hurry up and come on. This one, I hate this one. Lifted in the drift train. But as I was saying, Hot Pursuit was a good game. Because that's when I think the... I'm not sure, I think that's when you could become the cop as well. That's when it all got implemented into the game. Like, I find this build perfect, but you know, like, when you crash, it's hard to control from it. You need to get 43,000 miners. 1.7 miners, yeah. And plus with this game, you always have to look at the map. When you're doing races, you gotta always look at the map. Come on. But as I was saying, Hot Pursuit, I love that game, because I can remember you had the Pagani, you had everything back then. And you had the Remington. Oh, that car was sick. That Remington, oh. And this is one thing I hate sometimes, you know, the AI in this game. The AI just pop out of nowhere. And then plus you have those normal drivers, you know, like, that random Hot Wheels one. It'll pop out of nowhere, when you go into an intersection, it'll just pop out of nowhere and hit you, and that takes a piss. I was doing the race with Nakai-san's car, and it, 3 times I had to restart that race because when I crossed the intersection, a car popped out of nowhere. It's like, what the fuck, like, come on, man. You try evading it and you can't, what the fuck. But anyway, I'm definitely past this race. But anyway, let's see how this goes. Let's bring someone back, the quality of gameplay, like, for example, Drive Club. But you can drift with, like, when Need for Speed and Drive Club mix into one, but an open world map. And with the, the gameplay quality of, let's see, what's a good car racing, it's got good. You can say Drive Club even got good, how cars look realistic, so, exactly like that, go somewhere around the world, because as you can see, this is probably, I don't know where this is, because I'm not known in America. But, for example, I'm not sure where this is, to be honest. Let's just look at the skyline. I'm not sure where this is, seriously. Some half a medical just looks exactly the same, like, skyline wise. But anyway, as I was saying, take it somewhere different. Like, I can remember, GTA, the old GTA, I think it was 2, it was in London. Where everywhere else has been in America. Like, do somewhere different. Put it out there, like, go to a different country, go to somewhere that's got good roads, so like, go to Australia, go Switzerland, because the roads in Switzerland are like, there's Germany, we can go, there's like, we can't go, I was going to say Germany with the Autobahn, but in this game we already hit 200 and some of my power without the Autobahn. Drift in this. 3,000. Oh, yeah. Beat that greatly. But anyway, I'll get more into it, I'll keep continuing playing more and more, seeing how far I get. As you can see at the moment, I've got, when I left, when the last episode was, I was on about, I think, 12,000 speed points, not even that, probably less, and now I'm on 161, so I'm just going to keep going. If any special race does happen, I'll make sure that I quit the race, and I'll make a video on it. Anyway, thanks for watching, please leave a like and also subscribe. See ya. And when you go, you got my body, got my body, got my...